Alright, good morning, students. I believe you're having a nice time in this COVID-19 period. Please try to be safe, observe all the rules from CSCSC. We have missed you so much, and we hope to have you back to campus soon. Today we'll be looking at program development. As our custom is, let us pray together. Father, we thank you for thus far you have preserved our lives, especially in a time like this. Lord, we are grateful. I will ask, O God, that as we study, you will teach us all things and bring all things to our remembrance. To the praise and glory of your name, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before now, we have been looking at program development. We said earlier that software is a program that tells the computer what to do and how to do it. This implies that without the software, computer will practically do nothing or will not be able to do anything at all. Programs are a coded set of instructions that instruct the computer to perform a particular task. Now, to write a good program, we need to develop an algorithm and a flowchart. So, we have to know what an algorithm is. An algorithm. An algorithm, as we said earlier, is a step-by-step method to solve a particular problem. So algorithm is step-by-step method to solve a particular problem. And we said that algorithms can be represented using two methods. Number one is pseudocode, and number two is flowchart. It's important for us to know that a pseudocode is an algorithm, but in this case, it uses a mixture of English notations, some mathematical notations, and some selected keywords from a programming language. So most of the time when we say algorithm, we mean pseudocode. Why in the case of a flowchart? A flowchart is a graphical or pictorial representation used to solve a given problem. I repeat, flowchart. So with a flowchart, graphical representations or pictorial representations used to solve a given problem. It's important for us to know, in other words, we can say that flowcharts are graphical representations representation. Graphical representations of an algorithm. Of an algorithm. So, let's take an example of what an algorithm is, then we proceed. Example one. Before we consider this example one, let's look at flowchart symbols. So let's say flowchart symbols. In trying to draw a given flowchart, there are various symbols that you can make use of. Number one is begin and end symbol, which is oval shape. We call it begin and end symbol. Begin and end symbol. Other symbol we have is the parallelogram, which is the input and output symbol. The input and output symbol. The next one we have is the process symbol, which is a rectangle, which is called the process symbol. The next one we have is the decision symbol, which is a diamond. Decision symbol. Decision symbol, which is a diamond. The next one we have, we have the flow lines, because that direction of our flow chart calls for flow lines. And we have a circle, these are connectors, on-page and off-page connectors. On-page and off-page connectors. Connectors. Now let me explain these symbols again to us. The begin and end symbols are used to depict the beginning and the end of a flowchart. The input and output symbols are symbols that we use to get an input from the user, or to display an output from the computer to the user. The process symbol are symbols that we use to depict all operations that we carried out by the CPU. So any process that the CPU that will help us to handle, we use the process symbol. Then we have decision symbol. Decision symbol is in a place whereby we have to make alternatives from to check whether a number is input or odd, or check whether a number is positive or negative. So we use that. So we use the flow lines to depict the flow of our graph and the way we ought to go. So the on-page and off-page connector, for example, this is a page. You are drawing your flow chart on page 1, this is page 2, and this is page 3. So maybe you are trying to draw a flow chart on page 1, but while you are drawing your flow chart on page 1, then it's exceeding page 1. If you want to continue your diagram on this part of the same page, you use on-page connector to depict it. But if you want to continue your diagram on the next page, you use off-page connector to depict that you are continuing a diagram that was in the previous page. I repeat, when you are continuing your diagram on the same page, maybe you want to continue your diagram here, you will use the on-page connector to do it. For if you're moving to a next page to continue a particular flowchart, we now use the off-page connector symbol. That is the case. Let's look at example one. Example one. Example one. Draw a flowchart. Write an algorithm. An algorithm and draw the corresponding flowchart. Of a program that will add two numbers. So we want to write an algorithm and a flowchart of a program that will add two numbers. So the key word here is add two numbers. So let's begin our flowchart. So the algorithm does have begin, then, so want to add two numbers, which can be A and B or X and Y. So let's say, let's be A and B. So what we say, impute the first number or you say impute A. Then next line you say impute B. Then next one you say sum A plus B. Print sum, then end. That's the algorithm. Now let's look at the corresponding flowchart. The corresponding flowchart is the begin. Begin has this symbol, so we draw use the begin symbol. Begin. Use the impute symbol. You say impute A. Also use the impute symbol. You say impute B. Then you use the process symbol. You say sum A plus B. Then we use the output symbol. We say print sum. Then we use the end symbol to end. So that is it. It's also possible for us to do this, to join these two processes in one stage. For example, we say begin impute A comma B sum A plus B print sum end. Thank you. This is an example of an algorithm, and this is the corresponding pseudocode. So this is the flowchart. This is the flow chart.